Hi, I'm Aaron Fechter. I'm the guy that bought 10 samples of the chips, which I call Z-Tats, from 10 suppliers in China, so that I could try and find one supplier. It's just one, that's all I wanted to find, that would deliver me working chips. You all promised me working chips. Here are your DHL bags, every single one, okay? All of you guys sent me your samples, and I'm not sure that the samples that you sent me didn't all come from the same place. I'll show you the boxes. Okay, here they are. They all look just alike. Look at the tape on these boxes. It's exactly the same color. Okay, here's the one from Sophie and your company name I can't pronounce. Here you go. Here's Andy and Kevin. Here we go. This is Good Best. Okay, Penny, Ching Shang, Antec. Okay, all these chips, okay, out of all these chips that I ordered, 60 chips, only two of them are usable. Now, there's no reason to mistrust me. There's no reason at all, and I'm going to tell you why. I'm the guy that started the restaurant chain in America known as Chuck E. Cheese, originally known as Showbiz Pizza Place. I also created the Rockefeller Explosion, and I originally created the game called Whack-A-Mole. I'm coming out with a new game next year that I need to use these chips in that I ordered from you guys. Okay, so here, for example, is what this chip looks like. Okay, it's a one-time programmable chip. That means if anybody writes a program and burns it into these chips, the chip cannot be used for anyone else or any other purpose after that. So these chips have to be unused. Now, how do you know if this chip is used or not? You have to put it on a test device. There's no way to know other than testing it. So I'm going to show you my test device, how I know whether these chips are used or not. And yes, I have to admit, it is kind of amazing. I'm still using Apple IIe computers. I do, because that's the way I burn these chips. And all I wanted to do was find a large supply of these chips. I need thousands of them. And that's why I made this experiment where I bought all these chips from you guys. My purpose was to find working chips. You all promised me working chips, and no one provided them. I'm going to show you how I know. This is my development system that I use to burn these chips. I have here a supply of these chips from the 80s. These are chips that I've kept all these years that I have never used. And here's some more. Now we can take one of these chips out of my supply of never used chips and we can put it in our development system programmer. Just like that. Okay, we turn it on. That's to supply power. I have here an Apple IIe computer that's so configured so that it can test the chip. I pick the option to check for a blank part. It says ready to go. I press Y and look at all the F's that come up. These are the actual memory locations that are inside that chip and it says all checks out okay. Okay, turn off the power, remove the chip. I know that this chip is okay. Now, let's take a typical sample from Penny, okay, Chin Shang. Penny sent me 10 chips. Okay, the price was good, 82 cents a piece. Okay, but look at this. Okay, first, I put an identifying number, as soon as I unwrapped her products, I put her identifying number 6 on this chip, and after I tested it, I put a B on there, which means bad. Now, I'm going to retest this chip for you and show you. We put it in the development system. We turn the power on, we select to check the chip for a blank part, I press Y, immediately it comes up 58, part is not blank, 58. And the reason it says 58 is that's the actual returned value that's in it, the first memory location in that chip. Even the first memory location is burned. Okay, so this chip is bad. Okay, now, here's a bag of chips that I have not tested yet. Okay, I've tested all the others that I've been sent. Again, look, it's exactly the same tape. All the same tape that was used on all these boxes, which makes me believe you all are using the same supplier. Okay, so here we go. This box is from Ivy. You know who you are. I have not checked these chips yet, so let's check them together, shall we? I've have not even taken these chips out of their package yet. They still have the tape on them that you put on there. Or not you, but the shipper put on there. Okay, so we take the chip, we orient in here properly, turn on the power. What will it be? I'll bet you anything it's a bad chip. Check it. 02, bad part. Okay, how did I know? Okay, we're gonna keep that carefully right there. Let's check the next one. Bad part. It also has an O2. You know what that tells me? It tells me that all these chips were pre-programmed. They were probably pre-programmed for a product that wasn't manufactured. Let's check this one. O3. These parts were all pre-programmed for some purpose that was never fulfilled. And then they sold all these chips, or gave all these chips to you guys to sell to an unsuspecting market. So I've invested $450 in sample chips just so that I can find if there are any good chips in this world. 25, bad chip. Surprise, surprise. O2, again. You're even seeing the same numbers come up over and over, which indicates that these chips were programmed for a particular purpose and then not used, and of course are not usable. E7. Okay, all six. Six out of six, bad. All right? These chips are bad. You should refund the money to me, and you should tell me, you should try to find good chips. Because if you could find them, I'd buy them by the thousands. But you can't find them. You know why? Because Hitachi was sued by Motorola and forced to stop making these in the 80s or 90s. They were stopped. No more were made. You got my hopes up. You led me to believe that these chips were good and that I could get a good source of supply from you. But I can't. If I'm wrong, then get me some good chips. If you want me to test your entire batch, if you have 10,000 chips and you want me to test them to see if I can find what I can find, I'll test them for you. But I will not allow you to charge me for chips that are bad. You should take a lesson. You should each refund me the money that I paid you for these chips, anywhere from $30 to $100 for these samples. Refund my money to me, because it's a lesson you should learn, not a lesson that I should have to pay for to teach you that you're distributing bad chips. I'm going to fight to get my money back. I'm going to ask PayPal to penalize you and to get my money back, or to close down your PayPal accounts. Or you could work with me, because I am a big customer. I'm a customer who could buy thousands of chips from you. Not only this chip, but all the chips that are going to go in my new game. I'm going to be looking for suppliers, but I need honest suppliers. Not people who will sell me bad chips and then not give me a refund. Now, it would be stupid for me to send you these chips back and put good money into postage to send these chips back to you, because they're bad. Just go get some more from the same supplier that you got these chips from and test them yourself. If you don't know how to test them yourself, it just proves even further that you don't know whether these chips are good and bad, good or bad, and I do. I'm the only one who does. If you test those chips yourself and you say they're good, then send them to me, and I'll test them on video for you and show you whether they're good or bad. I'll pray they're good. I need these chips. I'm not causing trouble. I'm the good guy here. Give me my refund, or you're the bad guy.